So good morning all of you. So let us start today's class. So as we have discussed one problem of ladder friction in the last class, so today let us do one more problem. So I hope you can see the question. So the question, what it is, a uniform ladder. I told you, okay, uniform ladder of weight 200 Newton. Clear? So the concept, that is, what is uniform ladder? Uniform ladder means the weight is, the self weight of the ladder will be acting in the.
So konni.
Bisuni sir kichi.
Okay. Now you can see.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, uniform sir. Ladder of weight 200 Newton. Uniform ladder means the self weight of the ladder is acting in the center of gravity. So as
yes,
you
sir.
Can see in the diagram, this is the self weight of the ladder, which is acting in the center of gravity. The center of gravity is denoted by G here. Now the length of the ladder is how much? 4.5 meters. As you can see, the total length of the ladder, and the name of the ladder is A, B. Now this is actually resting where? This is resting on a horizontal ground and leans against a rough vertical wall. It is resting on a horizontal ground and it is leaning against a rough vertical wall. Clear? So both are rough. It is a rough horizontal ground and this is a rough horizontal wall. Clear? So the coefficient of friction. So by this you can know, here you see the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor. This is the ladder and this is the floor. The coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor is 0.4, that is given to you. Clear? And between the ladder and the vertical wall is 0.2. Between the ladder and the vertical wall, it is 0.2. So here two coefficient of frictions are given to you. Clear? So that means the ladder is supported by a rough vertical wall and rough horizontal floor. Both are rough. Okay. So when a weight of 900 Newton, how much? A weight of 900 Newton. Clear? Weight of 900 Newton is placed on the ladder. So somewhere 900 Newton is placed at a distance of 1.2, at a distance of 1.2 from the top of the ladder, at a distance of 1.2 from the top of the ladder. So from 1.2 meter from the top, here a weight is placed, and that weight, you know, always it acts in the vertically downward direction. The weight of the ladder is also acting in the vertically downward direction. Now the ladder is at the point of sliding. So how does the ladder slide? The ladder will slide here in this way. This particular ladder, which is supported downward by the vertical wall, it will slide in the downward direction. So frictional force will be upward to the direction of motion. That is opposite to the direction of motion. Now here, this ladder, it will slide towards the right side. Frictional force will be towards the left side, opposite to the direction of motion. So
yes,
here you have, let us find out, as there are, this is supported by two surfaces, rough vertical wall and rough horizontal. So you have two supports here, okay, two contact surfaces. So this is the contact surface at point A. You can see the point is blinking here. So this is one reaction you'll get. And you know that reaction is perpendicular to the contact surface. This ladder, how to find the direction? You will draw first perpendicular line. Then here, this particular, first you have to draw the perpendicular line. Now, next is what? Here, how to find the direction? So this ladder cannot go downward. So reaction is, upward. So this is how you get the direction. Similarly, find out the reaction here. This is first to draw the perpendicular line. This ladder cannot go, it cannot wait.
Go backward.
It cannot go this side. It cannot go to this side because of the presence of the vertical wall. So the reaction is opposite. Clear?
Opposite, yes.
So in that way, you have to find out. So So totally you have two reactions, Ra and Rb. Ra is acting at point A, Rb is acting at point B, you can see. And there are two frictional forces. One is here, Fa. Why Fa? Because it is acting at point A. So you know that frictional force is coefficient, that is mu A into Ra, coefficient of friction into normal reaction. Okay, this is acting towards this left side. Okay, now Fb, this is the one more frictional force which is acting in this direction, you can see, because the ladder will slide downward, so frictional force is opposite to the direction of motion. What is Fb? Fb is mu b into Rb. Fb is mu b into Rb. Fa is equal to mu a into Ra. I hope you understood.
Yes,
okay,
yes,
so totally how many forces are there? This is one force, frictional force. This is the reaction force. This is the active forces. That is one weight you are placing, 1.2 meter from the top. This is the self weight of the ladder, and this is the frictional force, and this is the reaction. So total how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Six forces.
Okay. Now all these forces, are they passing through common point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, they're passing through point. No, they're not passing through common point. So frictional force at point B and reaction at point B, they are passing through point B. This force, that is active force, the weight, it is passing through point E. Self weight of the ladder is passing through point G. G is center of gravity. And Ra, reaction at A, and frictional force at A is passing through point A. So two forces are passing through point B, two forces are passing through point A, one force at point E, one force at point G. Okay, so maximum number of forces are passing through where? It is passing through A or
point
B.
B.
So you can take A or B. When you're taking movement, you can take movement about point A, or you can take movement about point B. You can take movement about point E also. You can take movement about point G. You can take movement about point C also. So it's up to you. You take any point, answer will be same. Okay. So we are taking, so in order to solve the problem quickly, we will take that point where more number of forces are passing. So ultimately what will happen? So those forces, the movement of those forces which are passing through a particular point, by of which we are taking as the movement center, that is called as movement center. So those forces movement will become a zero. That is why we are taking that concept in order to solve the problem in a quick way. Got it? So what you have to find first, you have to find the angle made by the ladder with the horizontal. So this angle you have to find, it is not given to you. So let us take this, assume this as alpha. You can take theta, beta, anything. Okay, let us take this as alpha. So this angle you have to find, and you have to find the reaction at the foot of the ladder. This is the foot of the ladder or not? A. So Ra, yes, you have to find, and reaction at the top of the ladder. That is Rb you have to find. So these three things you have to find, alpha, Ra, Rb, you have to find it out. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So let us solve this problem. Now, while solving the problem, what are the things that are given to you? Now, the things that are given to you here, let us write down. What is the first thing? Weight of the ladder.
Okay.
So weight of the ladder is how much?
200 Newton.
The weight of the ladder is how much? 200
Newton.
Okay. So next, what is given? Length of the ladder.
Ladder.
Length of the ladder is how much? Length of the ladder is AB. Okay.
Yes,
so AB is how much? Yeah, so AB is equal to 4.5 meter. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Not only that, coefficient of friction is also given to you. So coefficient of friction at point A is how much? Coefficient of friction at point A is given as, so coefficient of friction at A. How much it is given? See here, at point A. Point A means ladder and the floor or not? Ladder and the floor, how much it is given?
0.4.
So that is given in the question. Similarly, coefficient of friction at point B is how much?
0.2.
That is in between the vertical wall, rough vertical wall and the top of the ladder. So these are the things given to you. So there is one more weight which is there. Weight of what? Weight not of the ladder, weight on the ladder. Weight on the ladder.
Ladder.
How much weight on weight is there on the ladder?
900 Newton.
900 Newton. Okay. So that you can take it as W1 if you want. And this weight of the ladder you can take it as W. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So this 4.5 meter, if you want, you can take it as L. And this is mu A and this is mu B. So these are the things given to you. Now, I think this 900 Newton, which is the weight on the ladder, 900 Newton, it is placed at a distance of 1.2 meter from the top of the ladder. It is given, you see.
Yes.
1.2
yes,
from the top of the ladder.
Ladder.
Okay. So, that 1.2 from the top of the ladder, so this distance BE, BE is how much?
1.2.
Yes or no? So you see the diagram, BE is 1.2 meter. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now let us find out. Now, this particular directions, I hope it is clear to you. Now, you know, let us go to the question. Let us find out. Now, this angle is how much? This is angle alpha. Let you take alpha. It is the angle made by the ladder with the horizontal. Let RA be the reaction at A. RB is the reaction at B. Reaction at B. So, you have to find out. Now, let us take as a right angle triangle. So, in the previous class, as I told you, we'll take right angle triangle first. Now, triangle ABC, you can see the diagram. Triangle ABC is a right angle triangle or not?
Yes, triangle sir.
ABC is a right angle triangle. And you know, in the last class, we have said triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Then AC in triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. What is AC? AC is the base or not?
Yes, sir.
AC is the base and CB. CB is what?
Perpendicular.
And AB is what? AB is hypotenuse. Okay. So, keeping this in view, so AB is your hypotenuse. Now, keeping this in view, so let us try to find out what is BC. Can you say what is BC? As I said you in the last class. No. What is BC? What? So, this total length is how much? Hypotenuse is given to you or not? Hypotenuse is given how much?
4.5
meter. Okay. So, when hypotenuse is given to you, can't you find BC? BC is how much? 4.5. Yeah. Sin alpha.
Yes, sir. 4.5 sin alpha.
Just try to recall last class.
Yes, 4.5
sin alpha. Similarly, what is AC? 4.5?
Cos alpha.
Very good. Because you don't know what is alpha. 4.5
cos alpha.
I hope you understood how you got this.
Yes, sir.
Got it? Now,
yes, sir.
What is AD? Please see here, AD. AD is AC by 2 or not? Till here it is okay. So next is, what is AC? So AC, can I write, because why you can, how can you write AC is equal to, sorry, AD, you can see, is equal to CD is equal to AC by 2. Can I write?
Yes, sir.
How? Because this particular weight, that is the self weight of the ladder, it is acting in the center of gravity or not?
Yes, sir.
This vertical line divides this line into two equal halves. Got it?
Yes, sir.
It divides into two equal halves. Yeah. Now, can I write, now in this triangle, please see. This is one right angle triangle or not?
Yes, sir. Right angle triangle.
So, in this triangle, so let me write the name of the triangle. Which triangle? In triangle ADG.
ADG.
ADG. You can write GDA, ADG or AGD, anything. In triangle ADG. This is a right angle triangle. So, in this triangle, what is AD?
AD.
What is AD? AD is nothing but what? Are AG cos alpha or not? AD is?
Cos alpha.
Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
AG?
Cos alpha.
Cos alpha.
I hope you understood.
Yes, sir.
Then what is AG? See, AB is how much?
AD.
4.5 meter. So this is center of gravity means 4.5 by 2 or not?
Yes,
what
sir.
4.5 by 2? 2.25. 4.5 by 2 is
2.25.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
See, this ladder is 4.5 meter. Center of gravity means half.
Sir.
This is 2.25. This is also 2.25. So 2.25 cos
alpha.
I hope you understood. Next.
Yes, sir.
What is AH? Now, next, which is the triangle? Let us take one more triangle. In triangle?
AHE.
AHE. Or anything. AH in triangle AHE. AHE is a right angle triangle or not?
Yes.
AHE is a right angle
triangle.
In this right angle triangle, let us find out what is AH.
AH. AE.
AE cos alpha.
AE cos alpha. Very good. AH is equal to?
AE cos alpha.
Cos alpha. AE cos alpha. Now what is AE? See the diagram. Now AB is how much? AB is 4.5 meter or not?
Yes, sir.
And what is BE? It is 1.2 meter. If this is 1.2 meter, can't you get AE? 4.5 minus 1.2. 4.5 minus
1.2.
It is how much?
3.3.
So this distance, AE.
Yes,
AE. Okay, this distance is 3.3. So 3.3
cos alpha.
Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
This data, you need it for solving. Then you may ask, sir, why you have not found EH? You can find. Can you say what is EH? 3.3 sine alpha. What is GD?
2.25
sine alpha.
If you need it, then you can also write down. There is no issue. But
yes,
these values, if you have, you are in need, when you are solving the problem, that when you are doing that, using the condition of movement. Got it? So,
yes,
let us take now. I hope you understood till here. Now here, these all the forces are not passing through common point. These are coplanar non-concurrent forces. So, in case of coplanar non-concurrent forces, what are the three equilibrium conditions?
Sigma H, sigma B,
summation,
sigma B,
yeah, summation sigma of A. H is equal to 0. summation of h equal to 0 means summation of all horizontal forces, all horizontal components is equal to 0. Summation of v equal to 0 means summation of all vertical forces, vertical components is equal to 0. And summation of m equal to 0 means movement of all the forces acting on the body about a particular point is 0. So for this particular problem, what you want to take as the movement? Movement about which point you want to take? I told you, in order to solve it quickly, you have to take that point as the movement center where the number of, maximum number of forces are passing. So maximum number of forces are passing through point B and point A. What you want to take? A?
Point A, A.
So let us take point A as the movement center. Sir, I want to take point B. Okay.
Yes,
so you can also try using point B. You'll see that you'll get the same answer. Okay, so let us take each one condition individually. So what is the first condition? The first condition is summation of h is equal to 0. Now, total how many forces are there? Total 6 forces are there. Clear?
Yes,
so out of the 6 forces, how many are horizontal forces? Please look into the diagram. How many are horizontal forces? How many are horizontal forces? There are how many forces?
Two forces.
One is your RB, the other is your
RA.
FA. One is your RB, horizontal forces. One is your RB, and the other is
FA.
Okay, so you know the sign convention. Okay, the sign convention is this is positive, right side is positive, left side arrow is
negative.
So you can write it in this way. So RB
minus FA
minus FA
equal to 0.
0.
Yes.
Okay. But yes, you know what is FA. So let us write FA. You had, let us substitute the value of FA. So can I, okay, let us write RB
equal to
is equal to
mu A
R A.
Mu A
R A.
Into R A.
R A. What is mu A? That is also given to you in the question. Let us see what is mu A. That we can write it here. Okay, sorry. This is what? Mu?
Coefficient of friction.
Mu A. That is 0.4. And this is mu
B.
B, that is coefficient of friction at point B.
B.
So mu A is how much?
0.4.
So let us substitute. So it is 0.4 R A. 0.4 R A. So let us take this as equation 1. You don't know what RA, it is not that. Okay, so this is one condition. Now let us go to the second condition. What is the second condition? Summation of V vertical forces equal to 0. So how many vertical forces are there here?
Four.
So total 4 forces. Downward is negative, upward is
positive.
So let us take the right positive first, that is FB.
Yes,
FB
sir.
Plus
RA.
FB RA. Plus RA.
Minus 900.
Equal to 0.
Equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So,
yes,
what is FB here? FB, you can write it as mu B.
Mu E. B R B.
R B.
Mu B R B. Plus R A. Let these two values, 900, 200, take to the other side. So, it will become 900 plus 200.
1100.
Newton.
Equal to
So you know what is the value of mu b? So mu b is also given
जीरो
to
पॉइंट
you.
टू
It is mu b is how much? 0.2.
जीरो
Okay.
टू
So 0.2
इनटू
into
जीरो
RB
पॉइंट फोर अच्छा
0.4
आरे वो
into
आरे
RB. Okay, so this value of RB is how much? Okay,
0.4 आ रहे
that we'll substitute
यस
later on. Next step, let us substitute.
सर
So plus RA
इक्वल टू
equals to
1100
So in this equation, the value of RB you shift here. RB value is how much? 0.4
0.4 आ रहे
RA. Can I substitute here?
यस सर
0.2
इनटू
zero
जीरो
point two
फोर
into 0.4 RA.
फोर आ रहे
0.4
आ रहे
RA plus RA
इक्वल टू 1100
equal to 1100. So 0.2, let us calculate this 0.2 into 0.4 is how much you're getting? 0.08.
0.08
So 0.08
08
RA plus RA
1100 इक्वल टू 1100
equal to
1100
1100. Okay, so RA value will be RA is equal to 1100 by 1.08 or not? 1100
Yes, sir.
by 1 point, so this is 1 RA plus 1.08.
08.
So this will solve 1100 divided by 1.08. So how much you got? 1018.51.
0.18
Let us round it off. Can I write it as 52?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So the value of RA you're getting as RA is equal to 1018.51 Newton. So one of the values you got, that is reaction at A. A is what? Reaction at the foot of the ladder. Reaction at the foot of the ladder. So RA, you got it. Clear? So reaction at the foot of the ladder, this part is complete. That is, second part is complete. RA, you got it. Now let us find RA, you got it. Now let us put the value of RA here in equation 1.
Yes, sir.
Let us substitute the value of RA in equation 1. So what is RB? Equation 1 is
Zero
what?
point
RB is equal to 0.4
four.
RA. You got it from here.
Yes, sir.
0.4 RA.
Into
So RA's value is how much? RA value you got just now as
0.18
0.4
into
multiplied by
0
1018.52
8 1.52 2
So 0.4 into 1018.52. So how much you got? 407.41. Again, round it off. 407.
Yes.
407.
Point 41.
Point 41
41
Newton. So here also you got the value of what?
RP
So what is RB? It is the reaction at point
B B
B. That is the top of the ladder and rough vertical wall. So this is the solution for the first portion. That is the third one. Reaction at the
last
top of the ladder. So one more thing is left out. What is that? Angle
horizon.
Ladder with the horizontal.
Horizontal.
How to find that? Got it? So this is completed. The second. So two things we got it. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now let us find out. Use the third condition. What is the third condition? Summation of M. We have taken it as A. Summation of M is at point A. That is moment about point A. Let us take it as zero.
Zero.
Equal to zero. Okay. So this is the third condition. Now total how many forces are there?
Six.
Six forces are there. So I told you, you can write in this way. We have to write how many? Six forces are there. You have to write down six statements, six lines. So what are the six lines? Movement of what are the all the forces? Movement of FB. Movement of
FB.
FB.
D.
About
A.
All are forces. Two frictional forces, two reaction forces, two active forces. Okay. So about point A.
A.
Then similarly, instead of writing, I'm writing like this. Do movement of RB. Movement of RB about the same point.
Yes.
Point A. Then next, movement of
900 about A.
About point A. Then movement of 200
about A.
About point A. 200 Newton. You can also write 200 Newton. Units also you can write. Then next is movement of
FA.
FA.
About
that
A.
Is frictional force about at point A. That is also about A.
Yes, sir.
Then movement of
RA.
RA about
A.
Point
A. Okay, so what are the forces which are passing through point A?
FA, RA.
FA and RA. So you know that movement of a force is what? Force into perpendicular distance.
Perpendicular distance.
So what is the force here? So FB is the force. In the second case, what is the force here? RB is the force. And movement of 900 Newton, it is which force?
900.
Movement of 200 is?
200.
This is the force.
Yes, sir.
You have to find the perpendicular distance also. Okay, 200 into force into perpendicular distance. Movement of FA?
FA.
This FA.
Zero.
FA into. Movement of RA? RA.
RA.
Okay. So, for all perpendicular distance, let us find out. So, the most important thing is movement center. Movement you are finding about which point? About point A.
A.
See, at point A, what are the forces passing? RA and
FA.
So, what is the perpendicular distance? Again, I'm saying, perpendicular distance means it is the distance between the line of action. This is the line of action or not?
Yes, sir.
Action. Distance between line of action and the point about which you are finding the movement. So this point is there on this line or not? So there is no perpendicular distance. So this is zero.
Zero.
Okay. Similarly, FA. For FA, this is the line of action or not? This is the line of action. What is the distance between the line of action of the force and the point about which you are finding the movement? This is also
zero.
Okay. So that is the concept. So or you can also directly put in this way. Whatever
zero.
Are passing through this is zero. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So RA into 0, FA into 0, this is equal to
0.
Next, let us find the perpendicular distance in this case. Moment of FB about point A. This is FB.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the, this is acting in upward direction. This is the line of action of the force or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And this is point A. So, this is the perpendicular distance or not?
Yes, sir.
This is your perpendicular distance. So, moment of this is what? Distance, this is the line of action and this is the point, moment center. This is the point about which you are finding the moment. So, this distance is the perpendicular distance. AC is the perpendicular distance.
Perpendicular distance.
AC is what? Perpendicular distance.
Perpendicular distance.
Okay. So, what is AC? Just now, you have found out here. AC is how much? 4.5
cos alpha.
So, let us write here. 4.5
cos alpha.
5 cos alpha.
Alpha.
Now, this is which force? Vertical force or not?
Vertical force. Yes,
vertical
sir.
Force?
Yes, sir.
So, place your pen.
Yes, sir.
If it is a vertical force, place your pen or pencil, anything, horizontally.
Yes, sir.
Hold point A and apply this force in upward direction. So, it will rotate in which direction?
Clockwise.
Clockwise. It is rotating clockwise.
Clockwise direction. CW.
So you have to write here
CW.
So, clockwise is the sign convention. We have taken it as negative.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So, yes, you can take clockwise positive, anticlockwise is a negative also. But
yes,
it is up to you. Okay. But
yes,
so the starting we have taken. So, let us maintain that clockwise we have taken as negative. Anticlockwise is positive. Got it? Next is
yes,
RB. Here is RB. The line of action of the force or not?
Yes, sir.
This is the line of action of the force.
Okay.
This is the line of action of the force. And this is the point or not about which you are finding the moment.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Here let us, this line and this point, you have to join it. So, this becomes perpendicular distance or not?
Yes, sir.
This is your perpendicular distance. See the pointer. Now, this distance and this distance are same or not?
Yes, sir.
So, BC is how much? BC is how much? 4.5
sin alpha.
So, that becomes your perpendicular distance. 4.5
sin alpha.
Okay. Now, how to find the directions? Now, this force is vertical or horizontal?
Horizontal.
Horizontal. Place your pen opposite, vertically. If it is a vertical force, place your pen horizontally. If it is a horizontal force, place your pen
vertically.
When you place your pen vertically, that pen should touch the movement center.
A.
Remember.
Yes, sir. A.
Because you are finding about point A, movement. So, hold it. Hold this pen. Apply this force. This will rotate in which direction? This will rotate
clockwise.
It will also rotate in clockwise or not?
Yes, sir.
So this is your clockwise. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next. 900. This is your 900. This is the line of action of the force.
Yes, sir.
This is the line of action of the force. And this is the point.
Yes, sir.
So, this is the perpendicular distance or not? AH
yes,
is the perpendicular distance. AH is the perpendicular distance. So, what is AH?
AH.
3.3
cos alpha.
So, you can write here 3.3 3.3
कॉस अल्फा
cos अल्फा. नाउ दिस फोर्स इज वर्टिकल और हॉरिजेंटल? दिस फोर्स इज वर्टिकल और हॉरिजेंटल?
वर्टिकल,
इट इज वर्टिकल.
यस
नाउ
सर,
प्लेस योर पेन हॉरिजेंटली,
हॉरिजॉन्टली,
होल्ड होल्ड दिस पॉइंट मोमेंट सेंटर,
यस
अप्लाई दिस, दिस इज द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन, सो इट विल रोटेट इन विच डायरेक्शन?
सर, एंटी क्लॉकवाइज,
क्लॉकवाइज. गॉट इट? सो दिस इज योर
यस
एंटी
सर, एंटी
क्लॉकवाइज.
क्लॉकवाइज.
ओके,
यस सर.
नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट इज 200. सो दिस इज 200.
यस सर,
दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स और नॉट? दिस इज
यस
द
सर,
लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स. नाउ यू से मी, व्हेन दिस इज द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स, दिस इज द पॉइंट अबाउट व्हिच यू आर फाइंडिंग द मूवमेंट, दिस बिकम्स परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस और नॉट? एडी,
यस सर, यस सर,
एडी इज द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस. व्हाट इज एडी? 2.25
2.25
cos अल्फा.
कॉस अल्फा,
तो 2.25
कॉस अल्फा,
cos अल्फा. अगेन दिस इज विच फोर्स? इट इज अ वर्टिकल फोर्स और नॉट? प्लेस
सर,
योर पेन हॉरिजेंटली, होल्ड दिस पॉइंट, अप्लाई द डाउनवर्ड फोर्स, सी द डाउनवर्ड एरो, इट
एंटी
विल रोटेट
क्लॉकवाइज,
इन डायरेक्शन.
एंटी
अगेन
क्लॉकवाइज,
एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. सो यू कैन राइट हियर एंटी.
क्लॉकवाइज, ACW.
ओके, यू शुड राइट बिकॉज और एल्स यू विल फॉरगेट द साइन कन्वेंशन. सो क्लॉकवाइज इज नेगेटिव, एंटी क्लॉकवाइज इज पॉजिटिव, समेशन ऑफ एम ए, एड ऑल. यू कैन, नो नीड ऑफ राइटिंग दिस जीरो बिकॉज ऑलरेडी इट इज जीरो ना, नो नीड ऑफ एडिंग. गॉट
यस सर,
इट? सो नेक्स्ट इज, लेट अस एड वन बाय वन, एफ बी इन टू 4.5 कॉस
कॉस
अल्फा.
अल्फा,
सो इट इज क्लॉकवाइज, सो दैट इज नेगेटिव.
यस
सो माइनस
सर,
एफ पी
इनटू
इंटू
फोर
4.5 कॉस अल्फा.
कॉस अल्फा,
4.5 कॉस
अल्फा,
द नेक्स्ट इज आर बी इंटू 4.5 साइन
साइन
अल्फा,
अल्फा,
दैट इज ऑल्सो माइनस
RP इनटू
आर
4.5,
टू
4.5 साइन अल्फा,
पॉइंट फाइव
साइन अल्फा,
साइन अल्फा
देन नाइन
प्लस, बिकॉज इट इज
नाइन
एंटी
हंड्रेड,
क्लॉकवाइज,
यस
नाइन
सर,
हंड्रेड थ्री
हंड्रेड
पॉइंट थ्री
पॉइंट
कॉस
थ्री कॉस अल्फा,
900 into, you can do one thing, all you put in brackets to avoid confusion,
यस सर, 2,
3.3
अच्छा, कॉस अल्फा,
cos अल्फा.
लास्ट
नेक्स्ट इज
200,
200 into
25,
प्लस
2,
200
3,
into 2.25
कॉस अल्फा,
cos. इज इक्वल टू जीरो.
जीरो,
इक्वल टू जीरो वाई? बिकॉज इट इज हियर, यू सी समेशन ऑफ एम ए इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इज द
यस
कंडीशन.
सर,
इज ऑल दिस यू एड इट इक्वल टू जीरो, समेशन मीन्स एडिशन.
यस सर,
नाउ लेट अस डू वन थिंग. यू नो वॉट इज एफ बी?
यस सर,
सो बिफोर दैट लेट अस डू वन थिंग, दिस माइनस माइनस लेट अस टेक टू द अदर साइड. गॉट इट?
यस
इट विल
सर,
बिकम प्लस और नॉट?
यस सर, प्लस,
900 into 3.3, 900 into 3.3 is how much? 2970.
70,
2970
70,
cos alpha, this value
यस सर,
plus 200 into 2.25,
200,
450.
450, कॉस अल्फा
कॉस
इक्वल टू
अल्फा
अल्फा इक्वल टू ए बी
इज इक्वल टू व्हाट इज एफ बी माइनस विल बिकम प्लस दिस माइनस आल्सो विल बिकम प्लस
यस
एफ
सर
बी म्यू बी आर बी और नॉट
यस सर
म्यू बी
आर
आर
बी
सो लेट अस डू वन थिंग म्यू बी इज हाउ मच सो लेट अस डू हियर बिफोर सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग लेट अस कैलकुलेट एफ बी एंड एफ बी दैट विल बी बेटर टू कैलकुलेट एफ बी इज इक्वल टू म्यू बी आर बी यू नो वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ म्यू बी एंड आर बी वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ आर बी यू गॉट 407.41 वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ म्यू बी
0.2
0.2
0.2 इंटू
407
0.2 इंटू 407.41
81.48
will take after decimal 2 81.
48
48 Newton. So FB is how much? 81.48.
48
81.48 into how much? 4.5. Into 4.5.
yes sir 366.66 66
66 plus. What is the value of RB? 407.41.
141
407.41 multiplied
41
by how much?
4.5 34
34. 18
33
double three point
4.334
34. I forgot something. Nobody said. So, sine alpha, bhuli, this you forgot?
अच्छा
Oh. Nobody said. Please wait. We have done mistake. This cos alpha.
मिस्टर यस सर
Cos alpha.
अल्फा
Okay. So why you have taken to the other side? Is it correct?
यस सर
Cos alpha sabu gutte side rakhiya. We'll keep all in one side.
यस सर
So this minus is minus. Okay. Equal
यस
to sin alpha we'll take to the other side. 1833.34 sine alpha. I hope you understood.
यस सर
यस सर
Okay. So these all are cos alpha. That means you can solve this or not. Let us
यस
solve 2970 plus 450 minus 366.66.
सिक्स सिक्स
3053.3
3 4
जीरो फाइव थ्री
पॉइंट
पॉइंट
फोर
फोर व्हाट कॉस
कॉस
अल्फा
अल्फा
इज इक्वल टू वन
वन
एट
एट थ्री थ्री
थ्री
थ्री पॉइंट 3 4 साइन अल्फा
हाउ टू फाइंड अल्फा विल से So 3 4 sine alpha. So this thing I can write it as like this sine alpha by cos alpha can I write or not?
यस सर साइन
Yes.
अल्फा बाय कॉस अल्फा इक्वल टू
Alpha बाय
कॉस अल्फा
इज इक्वल टू थ्री
जीरो
जीरो
जीरो 5 3 5 3.34
पॉइंट 3 4
बाई वन
डिवाइड
एट थ्री थ्री पॉइंट
वन एट
थ्री फोर
नाइन थ्री
पॉइंट
थ्री
थ्री फोर पॉइंट थ्री फोर
पॉइंट 3 4
थ्री फोर
तो व्हाट इज साइन अल्फा बाय कॉस अल्फा इट इज
कॉट कॉट
टैन अल्फा टैन
टेन टेन टेन
अल्फा बाय कॉस अल्फा इज टैन
अल्फा अल्फा
सो टैन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू लेट अस सॉल्व दिस 3053.34 डिवाइडेड बाय 1833.34 हाउ मच यू गॉट 1.66
1.66
1.66
66
विल टेक आफ्टर डेसिमल टू वैल्यूज 1.66
66
सो व्हाट इज अल्फा तो अल्फा इज इक्वल टू टैन इनवर्स 1.66
66
सो लेट अस फाइंड दैट आल्सो ओके वी हैव टू चेक फर्स्ट वेदर इट इज डिग्री और नॉट सो Yeah, where were we? Tan inverse, is it? We have to check first whether it is degree or not. So, yeah, where were we? Tan inverse, is it? So tan inverse calculator. So tan inverse, how much? Tan inverse 1.6.
1.66 1.66
Tan inverse, can you see here?
Yes, sir.
I'm putting here 1.66. Calculate. How much you got in degrees? 58.93.
6.93
Don't want in radians. We need in degrees. 58.93.
58.93 93
58.93.
93
Okay, so 58 degree 93 minutes. I think you know this symbol.
Yes, sir. Yes,
So this is the answer. So the first portion also you got the answer. That is the angle made by the ladder with the horizontal.
sir. Horizontal.
How much? 58 degree 93 minutes. 58.93.
Yes,
This is
sir.
how. I hope you understood.
Yes,
Okay.
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
So,
sir.
okay, we can stop here.
Yes, sir. Yes.